Andy Amerine, another one of my handy Andy tips. Today we're working on an indoor project and we're going to be talking about redoing the caulking of the bathtub, starting with a couple of the tools on it. But simple project, great indoor project, whether you're doing it in the winter or in the summer, it's a project that needs done. A major part of re-caulking around a bathtub, shower, toilet is going to be first off removing the old caulking. They make it easy with a caulking remover tool. Instead of trying to use a razor blade, which is going to cut, scratch, nick the towel or the plastic tub surrounds, use something that's plastic that's going to be able to grip the old caulking, and once you get it started, it generally peels off pretty easily. Once you get that caulking removed, using a regular cleaner to clean all the crud, the muck, the any growth, any mold off of it, you're down to a good, clean, dry surface, and then it's putting the new caulking on it. There's lots of different caulkings. The latex are a little bit easier to use. The silicones are a longer lasting one, depending on the bead of caulking you like. Comes in clear, comes in white, comes in almond on it, and there's good, better, best grades as far as the durability of the caulking. But a couple tricks to when you're redoing that caulking itself. Using a tool to get the right amount of the bead of caulking. More is not better. When you're doing a bead of caulking around the tub, a small, insignificant bead is going to seal the joint just as well of a bead of caulking that's super, super thick. When you get the smaller bead, they adhere better, they last a lot longer. So the trick with a tool like this is you can control the amount of caulking that is there and left on the surface itself. So, and add a little bit of weight to that tub if you're caulking around. So don't hesitate to be standing in the tub, sitting in the tub when you're doing it. That's going to compress the surface, make the crack at its widest point. So then when you're putting the bead of caulking on, it's going to sit. And then when it dries with the right amount and it's going to seal. Also, make sure you're allowing that caulking to cure before you go and get it wet and use it. So a good 12 hours afterwards, some of the caulking may take a little bit longer, but make sure it cures. This way, you're gonna have a nice clean bead, not a lot of excess, and if you're used to using your finger to smooth it instead of a tool, make sure you put like some Dawn dish detergent on to make your finger so it's not sticky, and you could smooth that bead of caulking very, very easily. Following these simple tips, even you could do the job like the professional. And check back soon for your next Handy Andy tip.